Hey guys, what's going on? Curve Murder 15 here, doing an audio vlog for this episode of ComVlog for a couple of reasons. One, the current situation that I'm in right now and the place that I'm staying at is a mom's friend's house because of what's going on in Adena Village still right now, and I don't really want to impose on recording any of their stuff indoors and such. And the second reason is because I wanted to share some footage with you about the train explosion that happened in Adena Village. Now keep in mind, I will be talking about this a little bit later. I've got some info on Game Bros and some con news first. But before I even get into that, I want to establish that the pictures and the video footage in this video, in this episode of ComVlog, was not done by me. I do not take any credit for the video or any of the pictures that were taken. I happened to get these off of HuffingtonPost.com, and the video was provided by WCHS. So, Game Bros is still going really, really good. Everybody's really liking the new intro because we do have a few episodes that have the new intro. I actually have it up right now if you're wanting to take a look at it. It's really, really cool. I worked not really hard on it, but I did do a decent amount. A decent amount of work on it. I've had a few people asking me where I got the new character sprites, like the little 3D animations, and I used this app called BuddyPoke and was managed to do some video with it and such, having the characters actually dance around and such. And it's a really, really cool app, and I really like using them for the show. Now, as far as production-wise, we may have to slow things down just a little bit. With the current situation going on in Adena right now, I haven't been able to get back to my house, and Thomas actually has just started a new job up in Parkersburg, and he hasn't been able to come down a lot recently, and plus, where he was originally living at was in Adena also. So we haven't been able to meet up, really, and do a lot of recording. We've recorded a few new episodes here and there, but nothing extremely new and nothing that continues the series that we really have going on right now. So if you see a stop of episodes, like, throughout the week, like there's only maybe one or two episodes during the week, that's why. We haven't been able to get together, record new episodes. Mike was supposed to be coming down this weekend, but unfortunately due to the increasingly bad weather that's supposed to be happening, because winter sucks, he isn't able to come down and record some episodes with us. So if you see a decline in episodes, that's why. We're not stopping production or anything like that. We just haven't been able to get together and actually sit down and record some new episodes. We will be doing it hopefully sometime in the future, though, whenever our schedules let up a little bit more and the weather lets up, getting rid of all this snow and crap. So hopefully in the near future we will be doing more episodes. Excuse me. Like I said, it's nothing, we're not stopping the show, it's just we haven't had time to record new episodes. So con news, not much to say about that. Like I said, the last time I was talking on ComVlog about going to conventions, the same conventions are still applying. The next convention I plan on attending is TriCon in April, then ColossalCon in Sandusky, Ohio in June, so of course HamasaCon in October, and then YamaCon in December. Like I said, originally I was going to go to Lexington Comic Con in March, but due to time constraint, money, and now especially with what's going on in Adena, I'm not going to be able to go, but that's okay. Sometimes you just have to go with that sort of thing. As far as panels, running panels, as soon as the panels open up for HamasaCon, I will be applying for Who's Line once again, and more than likely will be getting that. There's been talk of me trying to expand to different conventions to do other panels, such as Who's Line, or maybe even a Game Bros Q&A, and I'd like to get your feedback on that for the guys that attend HamasaCon. We did a Two Bros and Sissy panel last year, and we had maybe 10 or 12 people to show up. You know, honestly, that was a lot more than I actually expected. I didn't expect anybody to show up, to be 100% honest. But if that's something you guys are interested in, let me know down in the comments below if you would like to see something like that at HamasaCon this year. So, moving on to the big news. A lot of you know from my update this past week on Monday, there has been a huge explosion, train explosion, in Adena Village, where I actually live at. And for those that didn't catch the update, I'm going to bring you guys up to speed. And while I'm talking about it, I'm going to show footage of the accident itself, pictures, video, and like I said, I take no credit in any of the pictures or video that you're about to see. So basically what happened, and like I said, this is all hearsay. This is information that I've pulled from different newscasts, different websites and such, so don't take anything verbatim. This is just exactly what I've heard and read up on. So a train derailed carrying crude oil along the railroad in Edina Village, and it derailed going about 33 miles per hour and caused, I believe, 3 to 4 explosions, causing one house to catch on fire. And I believe there was only one injury, but it was not life-threatening. Thankfully, the people that owned the house were outside of the house. They were not there, so they were not injured, and thank God for that. Everybody in the Edina Village area and the Boomer Bottom area, because it's right across the river from Edina Village, had to be evacuated. And there were shelters put up around Falls View, Valley High School, and such. And people were also shown to go up to Oak Hill, to the Holiday Lodges, where myself, my mom, and my grandpa and my animals stayed at. The railroad company paid for all the rooms, as far as I know. And I greatly, greatly appreciate that, guys. You know, that's really great for you guys to do something like that. So, if to anybody watching this that works for the road company for, I believe it's CSX, thank you so much for that. So after that, we were able to come back down the mountain, and we're currently staying at one of my mom's friend's house. Route 61 going from Montgomery to Mount Carbon was closed off, but as of this morning, and as far as I know, one lane is open to get in and out, and I'm not sure how the road conditions are over there because of the weather, because of the ice and snow and such. So if you happen to have to go along that area, just be extremely careful. I haven't been out myself because we've only taken one vehicle. My car is still technically at my house right now. But just to everyone that was involved with this, you know, I'm just glad, you know, there was mainly just one injury as far as I know, and it wasn't life-threatening. And just everybody that's been out helping everybody with this, thank you so much. And if you know somebody that needs some help out there that's dealing with this situation, you know, try to give a helping hand. I've been trying my best to keep people informed about the situation when, you know, road conditions are opening up, when everything's turned, like the electricity had to be turned off for a while, when the electricity came back on. So I've just been trying my best to keep people informed because there's not a lot I can really do because I'm kind of trapped right now in a sense because of the weather. But, you know, all in all, it could have been a lot worse, but in my own eyes, you know, I think God had a big part of this, you know, helping people out and such, you know, watching over everybody. But, you know, in my own defense too, or in my own case, I really haven't had it that bad. You know, I have had a place to stay. I've had internet access to keep you guys informed about what's going on. Been able to keep up episodes of Game Bros and such. So everything's been really good. But that's the current situation that's been going on. And in the next episode of Calm Vlog, which will probably be in about 2 weeks, I'll update you guys on the current situation, which hopefully by 2 weeks, everything should be cleaned up and such. Well, guys, that's going to about do it for me. I'm going to head and hop off here and kind of try to relax a little bit. So this is Curve Murder 15 signing off.